Ryan McLeod, whom we talked to this morning, getting the opportunity between Fogle and Yamamoto. That's Draisaitl's spot. Quick chance. Yamamoto denied, and then Fogle unable to get it cleanly on his stick, but Yamamoto was tripped. Loading up Barry. Over to McDavid. Without Draisaitl, Kyler Yamamoto in the high slot. A blast, and that caromed off a hobble tan of open McDavid. Backdoor and tipped in by Zach Hyman. And the Oilers strike on the power play for a 1-0 lead. It'll be Hyman's 16th of the year.
Tyson Barry with a couple excellent keep-ins on this power play to track pucks down. That's the first one by Barry. Knocks down that puck, keeps it alive. And then again at the blue line right here. He gets all the way across from left to right to make sure this play stays alive. And then once this pass is made to McDavid, just a great give and go on the shot that kind of ricochets through. Cross screen, and then for Zach Hyman, he just plants himself.
David and Nugent Hopkins draw the assists, and for McDavid, that ties a career high. Points in 17 straight. Kostin, backhander score! Another feed from Nugent Hopkins results in a 2-0 lead for Edmonton. Klim Kostin with his third as an Oiler.
Oh, what a backhand shelf by Kostin. Good work down low to win a battle by Niemelainen. So important to make sure you're coming out of the zone. And then a poised play at the line by Nugent Hopkins. And this shot kind of gets fumbled a little bit. It's Janmark that just tries to get it through. And a lucky hop right to Kostin, who just finds himself wide open in front of the net. Goes to the backhand bar down. Unbelievable. And you know, those cross-seam passes, when they get through, it's so hard to defend against. Boom. Big hit right there by Vince Dunn on Yamamoto.
McDavid with Hyman. The trailer is nurse. He fires and scores. It's 3-0. And Edmonton running Seattle right out of the building.
Well, I don't know if you could have had a better start for the Edmonton Oilers right now. And you know what? Look at this. That head tap on Yamamoto. And then Yamamoto makes the play. Boom. He's down. But because of that little chip to McDavid, and Darnell Nurse's activation up the ice, he's wide open as the trailer, and he buries it blocker side on Grubauer.
And Seattle's high flip rolls inside the Oiler line, collected by Kulak. Kostin gave it away. Burakovsky has a breakaway. In on Skinner. Shoots and was stopped.
Can't have anybody taking a night off if they expect to win.
Because you don't have a guy like this, Connor McDavid, who can single-handedly pull your club out of a slump. Here, he puts it into the slot, got it back. Puljujärvi fired right into the pads of Matty Beniers. The rookie out of the University of Michigan. Turnover, quick shot. Puljujärvi makes it 4-0.
Here he just does some great work again. It looks like it's up for grabs. Hyman with the good stick. McDavid was right there to make that backhand pass to Puljujärvi, who twice found himself in the slot on this ship. But this is a no-looker. He knows exactly where Puljujärvi is.
Feathered around Hyman. Adam Larson turned it over, and a one-timer. McDavid stopped, and then Puljujärvi whacking at it short side. Ultimately, I'm just privileged to be on the same telecast. Face-off win for Nugent Hopkins, hammered in by Coop. Holloway.
Vince Dunn can fight, too. Tell you what, this is a step up for the kid in his first NHL scrap. A little bit of cross-check right there. He didn't like it. The second one, he turns around, gives him one back, and says, hey, I'm not going to take it. And that's kind of part for any young player. You're going to get pushed around. You're going to take some cross-checks. You have to let the league know, hey, I'm not going to take it until you're not going to take it. And he drops the gloves and gets in his first National Hockey League fight. And you can kind of feel that coming for Holloway.
Well, the biggest punch you ever saw Vince Dunn land came off the ice. Remember, in the American Hockey League when he knocked down the big fella?
It was a good right hand, too.
Here's a dish for Geeky, and a shot by Sprong goes in. And maybe Seattle will get some life from that fight. Daniel Sprong stays hot. That's his 11th and 6th in his last 8 games.
Chip backhand into the zone. And a backhand pass wide to Sprong, and he just elects to shoot it. It's Geeky that gets it to him, and there you go. He just kind of has it on that stick. There's really no tell to that shot. He doesn't bring it back.
Yamamoto gives up a foot in that matchup. Here's Kostin out to Nurse. A shot that's tipped. Nugent Hopkins gives it right back to him. Nurse looks for the landing shot. Redirected through. And Edmonton extends to a 5-1 lead. Kostin with the tip-in. That's his second goal of the night. And the Oilers back in front by four.
There certainly was a close call as McLeod was going off the ice before this offensive zone possession time. And I'm sure they're going to take a little look at it to make sure that it wasn't offside. But a great job by Nugent Hopkins to win a battle and get it back to Nurse for a second opportunity.
Oilers, again, it matched against this dreadful penalty kill for Seattle. McDavid back to Barry. Oilers scored on their first. Nugent Hopkins, McDavid wide open. A shot scores! And Connor McDavid post and in for his 32nd of the year, unless Hyman got a piece. And I think he might have.
Adjust the configuration here. Put Yamamoto on the top power play unit. McDavid takes that right side. Nugent Hopkins on the left. And just an excellent cross pass. That one right there. So difficult to make, but it does go off of something.
McDavid.
See how far out Jones was to try and make that save.
Look at Hyman again. Inside. Maintaining the puck for the Kraken. Largest lead of the night for the Oilers. Larson has shot, and that squeezed through Skinner, but Kraken couldn't finish on the back end. Tanev was there. One-timer, Larson redirected, save, and rebound tucked home by Tanev. And Seattle pushes back. It's 6-2. Brandon Tanev with his sixth of the year.
Yeah, Skinner had to fight off a couple shots through traffic. Good job by Tanev. This that almost went in, but it sprung in front with the screen. There's the first one with the high blocker. Gloves are used as a blocker on that save by Skinner. And then this one again, another one-timer by Larson. And this time Tanev is there as well. And when you have that presence in front, it's pretty hard to find that bobbling puck, and he pokes it home.
Who broke out in a big way last year, 28. Hasn't gotten going here and had his pocket picked. And it's a shorthanded breakaway for McDavid, and he's denied.
Scariest sight is seeing McDavid with a little bit of room in the offensive zone to go to work.
Kostin, beautiful. Nurse tipped on net by Janmark, and a save for Martin Jones.
Had something to eat. He is a chiropractor, so you know, both as his best man and his friend, he's always got his back.
And Derek Ryan, he's in unique company. We'll get to that in a moment. But that's a bit of score effects, Louis,
yep,
with a 4-0 lead. I'm not.
I can promise you the coaches won't like it.
No, exactly. Here's a steal by McDavid, heading for the net, shoots and scores. And Connor McDavid, you had the feeling you weren't getting through 60 minutes without him getting on the board. That's 32 and a 7-2 lead for Edmonton.
And I got to tell you, Connor McDavid last year would have passed this puck. And it's a subtle difference for McDavid, but it's a potent one. I'll tell you what, he is just bearing. I mean, he did have an open man where he could have threaded that across in a 6-2 game. I like the fact that he decided to take this shot.
It's 31-11 Seattle, but that's all that was in favor of the Kraken tonight. Edmonton, a devastating 4-goal blitzkrieg in the first period and cruising to a 7-2 victory.